Hello everybody, it's Niklas and welcome to this new video on OpenCADs. And in this video we are going to see how to work with variables in OpenCADs and why it is interesting to use variables. Subscribe to this YouTube channel if you like the content, let likes on the videos. First link on the description, the complete course OpenCAD is available, so if you want to learn OpenSCAD, if you want to work with programming, if you want to work with coding to create 3D models, this course will be perfect. It is on the first link on the description. It is a complete guide. We see in detail the different features on OpenCAD to perfectly master coding and create 3D models using this software. So this course is on the first link on the description. Second link on the description, this is a website in link with this YouTube channel. You have series of video tutorials on this website to learn software. And on the second link on the description, you will see a summary of all the courses that you can have. So let's start with a variable. Something that I'm going to do first is to create a sphere. So I will go on the left here and I will tap sphere. And I will just enter a value of radius for this sphere. And the radius will be 20. And I will enter also $FN to apply directly more subdivision. And I will put 100. I will close like this. Semicolon, I will zoom little out and I can generate my sphere just here. So this sphere, I will translate this sphere just on this area and I will use translate, and something that I will do is to use the x-axis, and I will put on the x-axis 100, on the y-axis 100, and on the z-axis 100. Bracket parenthesis, and after I can translate my sphere, this sphere will appear just on this area as you can see. If I want more, I will increase a little bit because for my example, it will be pretty bitter. So I will put 200 and 200. So now I want to position four spheres on each part symmetrically. How to do this work? I select this one and copy. First, just before to do this, I will tap sphere number one for the structure. And I will copy this one and I will go on this area and I will tap sphere number two. I will change the value for minus 200, 200, and I will validate the view. I will tap copy the sphere number two for sphere number three. I will just change for 200 and minus 200 here to have the sphere located on this position. And I will copy the sphere and I will go on this area, sphere. Oops, yes, sphere number four. And I will change the position for minus 200 and minus 200 to have this sphere here. So now what I will do is to create a scale value. And I will create scale here. And when I open, I can enter x, y, z axis. But I want to have my variable. So something that I will tap, it's variable and x like this. You can tap what you want. It's not a problem. Here, I'm just going to tap variable x, but you can tap what you want. Or in this case, I'm going to put scale x, for example, then scale y, just like this, and then scale z. After to do this type of work, I will close just like that, and I will just copy this one to position just below each translation. I think you need to position, in my example, the scale need to be just after the translate. You need to translate first and after to scale, it will be pretty better or it's not going to be very interesting. So let's just come back here. Let's just come back here. I will cut this one. And we will position this one here. And I will cut this one. And I will position this one here. It will be pretty better. Or it's going to be applied the scale value also on the translation. So this is why it's not going to be good. So I apply this one. So now on the top, something that I can do is just to tap I will type variable scale, just like this. And I will type scale x, 2 point, scale x equal. And I will copy and paste, so copy and paste scale y, and copy and paste scale z. And now I will replace the scale value by this one. And I can type, for example, when you use the scale in OpenCAD, it's between the value of your sphere by default will be 1. So if I type 2, I will scale by 2, so it means 200% all my sphere. You don't have to forget semicolon after, because if you don't put the semicolon, it's not going to work properly. And now if I validate, all my sphere are multiplied by 2. But something interesting, I can put, for example, 4. Here I can put maybe 3. And I will obtain this render, as you can see. If here I want to come back with 1, I can come back with 1. Why it is interesting, you can also work independently on this area. So for example, here if I put something like 3, 3, and 2, I can say, maybe on the first sphere, I want on the skill X 3, and I can add something, plus, and I can put 1. And if I put plus 1, I will have one more value for the scale on the first sphere. For example, the second one, I would like to have plus 2 on the Z axis, so I can type plus 2. And on the third one, maybe on the Z axis, I would like plus 1, but you can also apply minus if you need. And here on the Y axis or the Z axis, I can type plus 1 also maybe, and you can work like that. So this is the first interest to create a variable. Let's see a second example. In my second example, I will create first a cube, and this cube will enter 120, 120, and 8, 10. And I will put center equal true. The center equal true here. And finish with my parentheses. So it's okay for that. Now I can see my cube. I will create 4 cylinders with translation. So first I create my first cylinder. And for this first cylinder, something that I will do is to tap edge equal, and I will put 40, and radius 1 I will put maybe 10, and radius 2 10 first. I can just put the radius, so here I can put R, comma R equal 10. It's going to be pretty better. And I will also finish by center equal true, and $fn equal 100. And I will just validate my cylinder is located here in the middle. And I will translate this cylinder. Oops. I will translate this cylinder with translate. And I will work with a value of 40, 40, and 0. And now my cylinder will appear here. So after that, what I'm going to do is to select all this element, copy. First, I can put, for example, one more times for the structure cylinder number 1. And I will copy this one. We'll go here, past, past, and past. I will put cylinder number 2, cylinder number 3, and cylinder number 4. I will just change the value. So, for example, here it will be minus 40 and minus 40. And here it will be minus 40 and 40 and 40 and minus 40 to have my 4 cylinder. Okay, this is a cube. So on the top, I will create a difference. So I will type difference like this. And after I will open this symbol and I will finish with this symbol just like this. And thanks to that, I can create some Also, I think I forgot something. Let's just click on this area. What is wrong? Let's just come back just here. You have my different cube. I will type difference. I will open and I will open. So I want to subtract the different cylinder so I can open my symbol here from the cube and all the different cylinder. So I will close my symbol here. And now it's going to work properly. It was trained, it was not working properly. So now, if I want to add variables, I can, just on the top of the cylinder, create a variable. So I can go here, create variables, and I will type a variable radius. And I will replace here the radius by r equal, and I will replace by radius. Here r equal, I will replace by radius. So you can type what you want, the title that you want. It's not a problem. And try just to have something in link with what you want to do. It's just the advice and radius. So after to do this work, I can tap here. I can tap here what I can tap. I can just tap radius equal and I enter what I want. So for example, if I want 12, I can enter 12, semicolon, and now all my holes will have 12. So why it is useful? Because you can print this with a radius of 12 for the hole, and after you want to print the same models, but you only want 4. You just have one thing to change. It's pretty fast and it's pretty good. Something that you can do also is to have a base, like for example 10, and when you arrive on this area, if, for example, I want to select r equal radius and the first one I want 12, I can put plus 2, and thanks to that I will have 10 plus 2, and it means I will have 12 on this area, just like this. If I wanted plus 4, I will have 14. If here, for example, on the second one I want minus, I can type minus 2, for example, and here I can reduce the size. And on this array, I can type plus 2, and I can increase this one. And the last one, I can make minus 4, for example, the last one, and radius minus 4. And I can have 4 different sizes also. It's possible using this one. But so this is how you can work with variables. This is the interest. This is also the interest of programming 3D models, for the simple reason that you have this possibility to add variables, and after you can adjust at your convenience. You just change, for example, one value, and it is definitely pretty fast. So we are going to stop here for this video. If you like this content, subscribe to this YouTube channels. Put like on the description. First link on the description, the complete course is available. So if you want to learn OpenScad step by step with the course structures, this course will be perfect. It is on the first link on the description. It's a complete guide, different hours of training content separate in different modules and sessions to start from scratch and to have very nice levels in OpenCAD to create your 3D models. It is a complete guide. You will see the models, session of the course, first link on the description. And in the second link on the description, you will see the website in link with these YouTube channels. We work with tutorials on these YouTube channels to learn different software. And on the second link on the description, it is a summary of all the graphic courses to perfectly master these different softwares. For the next video on this channel, see you. Ciao, ciao.